chop it off because the trick of the obelisk, it needs to be just one piece. But this is really smart. One thing that you can do, you can take it in pieces and bring it to those pieces. Problem is, specifically with obelisk, you need to bring it all together. The Romans will construct really huge ships, obviously, because the obelisk is really big. They replace the obelisk and they will cover it. I've been told to say this, you're supposed to understand, sawdust.
Mm-hmm.
You know when you cut wood, the remains?
Sawdust.
Sawdust, yes?
Uh-huh.
I hope.
Uh-huh.
Now, you refill with this, so the room is packed with an obelisk and all of the sawdust in there. Sawdust will do two functions. One, it'll help the actual boat to float. Second, it'll prevent your obelisk to chip. Do you guys follow me so far? Mm-hmm. And then you have the rowers. So the rowers will give speed to the boat, so the boat cannot sink. Huh. You follow me? So, if the rowers feel too tired, little by little, do you guys follow me? So you need to go across the entire Mediterranean into a ship like that.
Wow.
How do you get on the ship?
Do you really want to know? Yeah, but
how do they get the obelisk onto the ship?
No iron. So how do you do it? 2,000 years ago, no iron to do
three trunks,
exactly.
So they roll the obelisk onto
Yeah, but not only, exactly. Not only just for the ships, they will do it as well for obelisks to be carried around. You use three trunks, you have, let's say, 10 tree trunks, okay, and you have the actual obelisk on top. You move the last one to the front, and the last one to the front, and it rolls.
How would you get it down?
Down, you get people towers tear it apart towards the down, and people to compensate because you
don't
get
so you don't
a lot of people to compensate.
It's like tug of war.
Well, it's basically called 10,000 slaves working.
Yeah.